importance of communication. Unfortunately, some people just don't do it, especially when it comes to the very sensitive topic of finances. Financial infidelity is the number one cause of crumbling relationships. And with us this morning to give us a better idea of how to handle the situation, our financial expert, Chip Cummings. Chip, great to see you, buddy.
You too.
Yeah, it's one of those things. It causes so many problems if you don't address it right away, doesn't it?
It does. Number one reason for divorce, hiding money, spending it in ways that your spouse doesn't know. A really good, solid marriage takes communication. We all know that. And communication on finances seems to be really difficult for most folks.
They don't want to talk about it. I mean, that, you know what I mean? It's almost like, don't talk about it. It might make things bad.
Well, you could have, you know, different levels of income that could cause some static. You could just have different spending patterns. Somebody loves to go out and spend a lot of entertainment dollars, as we say. And the other one is the penny pincher, wondering why we can't save 5 cents by going, you know, 10 miles to go get that elsewhere. So.
Right.
It's a difference of opinion.
So talk about this one, because I've always found this one really interesting. Is this whole, you're a couple together, yet they have separate bank accounts. How does that work and make things go well?
Well, that's a big one. A lot of people think that it's okay to have a separate bank account on the side. If I've got a hobby or a side job and I put the money in there, that's just mine to play with. And that usually does cause problems. I'm not saying it doesn't work all the time.
Right.
But in most cases, it creates a resentment that you're not spending this money together. And you look more like roommates. And it feels more like roommates when you're not sharing those expenses and making those financial decisions.
Talk about... this was, I thought, pretty interesting. I don't have any rich relatives, but all of a sudden they have all this money and they're spending, and you're thinking, where is this coming from?
Well, especially newlyweds, the first couple of years, you might not know any extended family, but a rich aunt dies, let's say, and all of a sudden you find yourself in the inheritance and you're going to be getting this pot of money. Well, I don't want to tell my spouse about it because then I may have to share it. She may have ideas on how to spend it or something like that, so we'll just set this aside over here. And that surprisingly hit the top five list.
No kidding.
Yeah.
And this one I thought was pretty interesting as well. Acting like you have a job, yet you still don't?
Especially in this economy. You've got people that are losing a job or they've been downsized and gone to part-time. And to try and keep up appearances, they say everything at work is fine. And they don't want to cause alarm with their spouse while they go out and find another job or pick up a second job on the side. So lying about your employment and your income is obviously another big red flag when it comes to money.
It just seems like there's so many ways that you can get into some trouble when it comes to your finances, right?
You can. Being open and honest, making joint decisions. In our household, we have a standing rule that if we're going to spend more than $100, we make a joint decision on that. And we look at what the ramifications are, where we're going to pull it from the budget, and we enjoy going shopping together and making those decisions. So that's the best way to keep harmony, as they say, in the household.
Or yes, dear, maybe.
Yeah.
Is that a good way to do it as well?
I'll make the decision, she'll confirm it.
but you don't want to try and keep anything secretive. Being out in the open is the way to go.
Especially for newlyweds. This time a lot of weddings are occurring, and having those discussions up front will avoid a lot of problems down the road. So it's important to talk about these issues right at the get-go.
Yeah, especially I have $4 million in debt. You don't mind, do you?
Yeah, no.
The wedding's tomorrow, by the way.
Hiding debt's a big problem.
Yeah.
You know, well, those will go away, or I'll pay them on the side. And sending those bills to a P.O. box or somewhere else, it's just a recipe for problems.
All right. Chip, great stuff. Good to see you, man.
You too.
All right. And, of course, we have some more details for you at the morning news page at fox17online.com. 817, and the lucky one this morning, Emily Riquette at Hudson.